Alexander César Léopold Bizet was a French composer of the Romantic era. He was born in Paris in October 1838 and later baptized as Georges, and was known by this name for the rest of his life till June 1875. In the 19th century, Paris has gained reputation of the musical capital of the world. Foremost composers and musicians from different countries of the world came here. Gioachino Rossini, Vincenzo Bellini, Franz Liszt, Frédéric Chopin, best singers performed at the opera stage. Renowned virtuoso musicians performed their concerts. In the 1820s, in French music, they formed a distinct genre, grand opera. Its formation was influenced by traditions of French lyrical tragedy and Italian opera seria. Grand opera was a monumental and lavish musical dramatical affair. Subject was usually historical, characters experienced both personal and social drama. Stage performances featured sets and costumes of extraordinary splendor. But by the beginning of the second half of 19th century, public became interested in the inner world of the common man, not in the exaggeratedly romantic experience of an extraordinary person. Music became more influenced by realism. Dramatic pathos and heroic pose were replaced by simplicity and sincerity. Composers tried to convey in their works feelings experienced by almost anyone in their life. Joy and sorrow, love and jealousy, despair and grief. At the same time, new genre appeared in the French operatic art, lyrical opera. One representative of which was Georges Bizet. His operas, The Pearl Fishers, Don Procopio, Ivan IV, Jamile, Carmen, and his incidental music for Alphonse Daudet's drama Les Arlésiens are masterpieces of the world classical music. Along with his orchestral and vocal works such as Fantasy Symphonique, Souvenir de Rome, Ouverture Patrie, or Old Symphony Vasco da Gama, he created suite of piano miniatures titled Jeux d'enfants, Children's Games. This 12-part composition was finished and published in 1871. For four hands performance on one piano. Later, by conductor Colonna's request, five of 12 pieces were arranged for orchestra and organized under the name of Little Orchestra Suite, first performed in March 1873. Today, I would like you to listen to original version for piano four hands performed by Katia and Marielle Labeck. Suite is opened by light and airy piece L'Escarpolette, The Swing, or Rêverie, means daydream or condition of being lost in thought. Passages of 16 notes are passed from one part to the next, imitating movement of the swing or transience of thoughts. Constantly changing tonal plan conveys emotional palette, which supports the melody meditation, in the lower register. Suite continues with a music impromptu letto P, the top. Rhythm of the bass part imitates movement of the top and the 16th. Now accelerating, now slowing down in its endless spin. In the main part, playful, laughing staccato of the 8, despite the main key of C major, changes in the chromatisms of the melody dramatically convey emotional delight of play. L'Epopée, charming lullaby virtuose for a doll. Each girl had her favorite doll, and she imitated scenes from life while playing with it. Here, girl puts her doll to bed. At the background of calm and drawing 8 sounds, wonderful melody, pure, sincere, and caring, almost always keeping its main key of B major, except at the culmination, where harmonic texture thickens, intervines in total deviations, and sounds somewhat tensely, excitedly, as if warning of little life dangers, then fades, quiets down, and softly return to the main key. Le chevaux de bois, the hobby horse, bright, quick, energetic scherzo, popular boys' amusement, imitating in play gallop, horse races, hunt, cavalry in war. Music very dramatically conveys this passion in bass part, measured rhythm of the horse with emphasis of pushing of first beat in 6/8 measure. In the main part, melody is contained in the rocking rhythm of the rider, repeating ligature to eighth with pause, all the while keeping the melodic rhythm of the verse. Tonal plan is varied and emotional, from C major dividates to F major, to D major, to B and B flat major, but asserts itself into A major. Such is the tension. Thank you. Le Valin, Badminton, charming miniature composed in the form of fantasy. Game is based on hitting a shuttlecock over the net. Here music very precisely conveys movement and state of this game. Dotted rhythm accompanied by measured alternating glissandos in 30 seconds. In both parts, give us a feeling of stability, good play, and amusement. It should be noted that in this play piece, not a single passage is the same as another, and it is based on a little chromatic fantasy, flight of the shuttlecock, if you will, or a whiff of the summer breeze. Trumpet and drums. When we listen to this march, there is no doubt that it has been composed by Georges Bizet, because either by rhythm or by melody, it echoes some numbers from his operas, namely March from the Fifth Act of his opera Ivan IV. In my view, this march is so unique in its imagination and narration that it is perceived differently every time. Here there is humor, satire, pompous gravity, dollish bellicosity, and even some echoes of caricature of Rondo a la Turca. Thank you. Les bulles de savon, soap bubbles, charming, weightless, crystal piece with short airs of three sounds, conveying shape of small soap bubbles, blown out of thin reed or pipe. This composer's rondino means small rondo, round. Performance is so refined and natural, with delicately changing tempo, now slowing with breath, now melting away with breeze. Melody is very fragile, where each tune is endowed with unique charm of chromatic variety, just like soap bubbles themselves. Les quatre coins, Puss in a Corner, amusing and playful piece composed as a skiz. First, let's learn the rules of the game. We need five players and a square area with four corners. One player is nominated Puss and takes his place in the center of the arena. Each of the other four players selects one of the corners and takes their place there. Play begins with the four corner players attempting to exchange places with each other in any direction. Puss attempts to gain a corner during the exchange. Should he succeed, the player left without a corner becomes Puss and takes the place in the center of the arena. It's not by chance that composer chose ringing and light key of D major for this esquisse. It is also not without tonal deviations and chromatisms in short tunes, which is generally characteristic of 19th century French music style, elusive emotional palette. And of course, rhythm, tempo, and dynamic convey action of the game. Running eights are associated with players trying to quickly and stealthily run from one corner to another. Pauses and slowdowns speak of caution and some cunning planning, and sometimes solid chords appearing in bass part remind us, even so, of the tense game action. Thank you. L'homme et l'art, blind man's buff. I think everyone knows the rules of this game and have played it many times. Composer internally chose form of nocturne and D flat major key as a short composition of a romantic or dreamy character suggestive of night, typically for piano. The general character of this composition is cautious, timid, and hesitant, related to the nature of this game. Player who is it is trying to catch another blindfolded by touch. Melodic pattern of short phrases is always encouraged by moving up as hope for success, then rounds to diminuendo as a small frustration from failure. Lengthy pauses after rounded phrases and tunes remind us of cautious moments of it, with his hands outstretched or trying to listen to surroundings. In the second bass part, we can perhaps hear quiet step of other players trying not to reveal themselves, or hesitant step of it as confirmation. Whole game is played silently, except for culminating moments of success in victorious forte. Saute-mouton, literally leap-ship or leap-frog in English. In English interpretation, playful caprice, a lovely piece of music, typically one that is short and free in form. Composer choose C major as main key, but endless chromatic and tonal inventions inspire performer to fantastic interpretation of this piece, which evokes smile, delight, and wonder. Games of this sort have been called by this name since at least the late 16th century. Rules, by the way. The first participant rests their hands on knees and bends over, which is called giving it back. The next player places hands on the first's back and leaps over by straddling legs wide apart on each side. On landing, he stoops down and a third leaps over the first and second and the fourth over all others successively. When all the players are stooping, The last in the line begins leaping over all the others in turn. The number of participants is not fixed. Melodic pattern of the piece includes constant repeat of triplets conveying leaping over something, playful race of the eights, and unstoppable clatter of chords complements the lively game. Petit mari, petite femme, little husband, little wife. Beautiful dialogue between mother and father. Children always reflect real adult life and their amusements. This marvelous piece very delicately conveys aesthetics of dialogue. At the background of soft and quiet accompaniment of second bass part, sound phrases of the upper register, colored by light emotionality with soft transition from main B flat key to parallel G minor, and adjacent keys of E flat major and C minor. We hear intonation of persuasion in sequences and doubt in chromatic tunes. Melodic patterns are filled with declamation of intelligent speech. They are calm and expressive. The Ball closes the suite, composed in style of galop, which is lively country dance, introduced in the late 1820 to Parisian society by the Duchess de Berry, and popular in Vienna, Berlin, and London as the final dance of the evening. Georges Bizet filled this dance with childlike lightness and cheerfulness, unstoppable energy and mischief by choosing a major key. Simple, memorable melody bewitches and carries away into dance of memories of carefree childhood. Into Georges Bizet's biography, we will understand that Jeux d'enfants, children's game suite, was composed during the likely happiest period of his life, when in 1869 he married his beloved Genevieve Halévy, daughter of his teacher, and not long before birth of his only son Jacques in July 1872. "I am tremendously happy," Georges Bizet wrote at that time to his friend and family member Hippolyte Rodriguez. Our next lecture will be about Dolly, suite by Gabriel Fauré.